Welcome back, gamers. I'm Chubub01. This is the beginning of a Let's Play on the 1998 game Thief the Dark Project and Thief Gold. This is one of my all-time favorite games, but it needs some setup before I jump in. So in this episode, we will quickly go through the history of the franchise, how to install a 25-year-old game on a modern machine, watch the creepy intro movie, and run the training mission. Plus, we'll play a little basketball. If you've never played Thief, and most of you have not since you weren't even born when it came out, it started with Thief the Dark Project, which is considered a sleeper hit, which means that sales were slow at first, but over the months after the release, because of word of mouth, because there was no YouTube and there were only a few gaming news websites, sales continued to increase. Looking Glass Studios, which no longer exists, actually listened to their fans, and while working on Thief 2, which is my favorite in the series, went back and tweaked the Dark Project. They fixed some bugs, removed some enemies from levels that they didn't belong in, and added some more levels and re-released it as Thief Gold. Thief Toon soon followed with much bigger maps, better graphics, but a slightly weaker story. Looking Glass Studios then closed their doors, and Eidos took over the series. Game technology changed a lot, and years later, Thief 3 was released, disappointing fans by leaving behind so much of the iconic art and the game mechanics from the originals. Fans quickly made mods to make the game feel as close as possible to the previous games. Now, don't get me wrong, it was still fun. It continued the overarching story and has a terrifying level in it, but it is a shadow of the first games. Pun intended. Then, after years and years of waiting, Thief 4, initially promoted as Thief, was released. Unfortunately, it was such a vast departure from the previous games, longtime fans panned the game. The tone and the feel was not like any of the previous games. The maps were difficult to navigate. It looked great, but it played like trash, and it seemed like they attempted to continue a story thread from the previous games, but at the same time tried to reboot the series into a more adult version. They failed, completely missing all the things that made 1 and 2 a magical experience, and in my opinion, they killed the franchise. There are no Thief games in production for the future. There was a fan-made Thief 2 expansion called T2X, which I also played, but only played it once, and I don't really remember much about it. So why the big history lesson? Well, you need to understand that I'm a huge Thief nerd. I've played the first three games a lot, and in various play styles and difficulty settings. I even made a fake blog in the late 90s and early 2000s as if the main character of the game was blogging what he was doing in the games. I'm choosing to play Thief Gold in this Let's Play instead of Thief the Dark Project, even though they are mostly the same, because I think Thief Gold is a little bit better. It has everything I liked about Thief the Dark Project, plus it's got some extra levels. Some people will disagree, and that's fine. I just wanted you to know what my headspace was concerning the two games. Because of the game being released in 1998, there were lots of limitations in the operating systems and the computer hardware, and this all boils down to it being a little challenging to get this to play on a modern system. So I'm going to walk you through how I got this up and running and drop some links below to help you get yours running. Yes, you should get this game. Everyone will have a different experience getting theirs to work, but the Thief community has been hard at work for the last 25 years, making sure it will work eventually for everyone. For starters, I actually own the discs, not the digital versions that you get from Steam or GOG.com, or is it GOG.com? I don't know. But the links will help you that I put below, even if you have those versions also. So before I began, I had to install Virtual C++ 2008 and DirectX 9 from June of 2010. And after that, it still would not install. Following the directions from the forums, I copied the Thief folder from my from disk 1 into my documents, so it would have been asked for administrator access. And then I did the same from disk 2 right into the same folder. Then I installed T-Fix, which is an automatic Thief game fixer, and it's made by fans. T-Fix lets you install a few mods if you choose to. I chose to use Thief 2 Skies and Water because they looked a lot better, as well as the improved models and such. but I did not choose the interactive candles since that was not possible until Thief 3, I believe. I got a few errors when running tfix, but it literally told me what to do and what to fix. It involved copying one file from the disk to a folder again and changing one text file to tell it I wanted English as the language. I did not like the desktop icon, and it would not seem to change to the built-in icons, so I found one online, and I made a custom shortcut on my desktop and changed it to the icon I wanted, which is essentially identical to the original from the Dark Project and Thief Gold. I launched the game, which should have triggered the intro movie, but it didn't. I double-checked my audio and video settings and my keyboard controls. I started the training mission, but again, still no movie. I can't play this game without the movies. They are a huge part of the charm of this game, and they are critical to the story. After some internet searching and poking around, I came up with nothing. They should already be working. Then I noticed there were two movie folders. One next to the Thief folder that only had two movies in it, and another inside the Thief folder that had them all in it. I simply copied them all and pasted them into the first folder that only had two. And then bingo. With that, enjoy the creepy introduction to Thief Gold. Yes, Thief does have some creepy elements to it near the end of the game. Okay, well, let's dive into the training episode. We're going to run it on Expert for one reason. It really makes no difference, except for one little thing. And so we're going to start it.
I was a kid. No parents, no home. Running messages and picking pockets to keep my ribs from meeting my spine. One night I saw a man. Folks just passed him by like he wasn't there. I thought he must have something valuable, so I snuck up on him and made a grab.
That's not for you.
Please, sir, I'm hungry. Don't tell the hammers, I promise.
What is your name, boy?
Garrett.
You have talent, lad.
Let go of me, old man!
To see a keeper is not an easy thing. Especially one who does not wish to be seen. We have a need for those as gifted as yourself. If you've grown tired of how you live, then follow me, and we will show you a different way.
Leave me alone!
As you wish.
I caught up with him just before he vanished into the crowd. It was the beginning of a very long education.
All right, and at this screen, we can change the difficulty, but we're gonna leave it on expert.
Welcome, young Garrett. In the nearby rooms, I will instruct you in the various skills you will need to survive. Please stay in the entrance area to each room while I explain the room's purpose. When you are ready to begin your lessons, proceed down this hallway to the first room.
I love those little intro movies. I love the artwork. It's so cool.
You must learn how to move unseen. Stay in the shadows. Avoid the light. The indicator on your screen will tell you how visible you are. Try to reach the top of the platform without being seen.
This is always kind of a weird room. You can see the stars. And it's just like...
I see you there, lad.
Try again. Remember, stay out of the well-lit areas
been talking.
Until you reach the platform.
Okay, I actually have to pay attention this time. Sorry. Anyway, this ceiling looks like... it's just some kind of starry wallpaper or something. I don't know. It's a really weird choice.
Well done. I did not see you approach. Yeah.
Open this door to continue. When the door is near the center of your screen, it will light up, indicating that it is selected. To manipulate
like that
selected
right there.
Doors and other objects, use them. Good. Proceed down this corridor for your next test.
Map.
Now you must learn to move quietly. Some surfaces are louder than others when walked upon. And moving quickly makes more noise than moving slowly. Listen to your own footsteps to hear how much noise you are making. The instructor will have his back turned. You must get to the top of the platform without being heard.
Yeah, so not a whole lot of talking I can do during the training mission because they're giving so much instructions. But yeah, hopefully it's obvious what it was that you're supposed to do, not walk on the metal.
Very good. I did not hear you traverse.
Beyond this door is a hallway that will lead you to your next task.
Oh, log me in. That's some weird stuff back there. Alright, anyway. I don't ever remember seeing that before. I think this is running. That's walking.
Now get your weapons. To pick up objects, select them by centering them on screen until they light up. Then use them. Choose your weapon now. Try readying your sword, and then your bow. You can always put them away again if you need your hands free. Now let's go out to the courtyard for some target practice. Ready your bow. Knock an arrow and draw back the string by holding down the attack button. Make sure you draw all the way back, or your shot will not have full power. Take aim, and when you are ready to shoot, release your attack. See if you can hit one of these targets. Good shot. Keep practicing if you wish. When you are ready to proceed, approach the training dummy and ready your sword.
Now it doesn't zoom in until you you have to hold it down quite a bit before it will zoom in like that. And then if you hold it too long, If you hold it too long, then his arm turns to noodles, and he just starts aiming wildly and then puts it down.
Swing at the target with the attack button. A quick tap will give you a slash. Move the tip of your sword to the left of the target for a left slash, and to the right of the target for a right slash. Hold the attack button down, then release for an overhead swing. Try both slashes and the overhead swing on the practice dummy. Good job. You're ready for a live opponent.
Look at this bush.
Practice against your partner. Enter the cobbled sparring area.
It's made out of, like, wood or something. Well, solid wood. Now, to be honest, you're not going to use the sword a whole lot. It's pretty much a last ditch.
Keep sparring if you wish. When you're done, leave the sparring area.
You've got no other choice.
That's enough sparring for today. Please walk over to the table.
Yeah, this is why we do it on expert. Because you can come around this corner, and voila, you can go here, which you cannot do on the other two difficulty settings. And what's in here? Why, a basketball court, of course. Oh. There goes my shot. Oh. there goes my chance at the NBA. Oh, man, that's terrible. Wow. I stink at this. Fine. Fine. You know what? Fine. And there is a... it says it's a bedroll. But it's not. It's a secret. Where you can read... some crazy stuff by the creators. We're just going to drop it. We can't do anything with it anyway. Where's the basketball? There it is. Hey, you want to play horse? And in case you're wondering, no, there are no basketballs in the game besides that one. And if I remember right, this may be the only secret area in the entire game. Oh, yeah.
Would you care for some refreshment before we move on, young Garrett? Please pick up all of the items on this table. Cycle through your inventory to see the objects you have in your pockets. Once an object is displayed, you may use it. Have something to eat if you wish. Then you may proceed. The next test is waiting on the other side of the metal door. The door is locked, but the key from the table will open it. To unlock the door, select the key in your inventory. Center the door on screen until it lights up. Then use the key on the door. Good. Now head down this hallway to get to your next test.
You shouldn't be surprised that the door went up. The doors do get kind of glitchy sometimes.
Now you will learn new movement skills. First, climb the rope by jumping onto it. Move while looking up or down to climb up or down the rope. Turn to change your facing. If you jump again, you will release the rope. Now climb the rope to get to the top of the
platform.
Good job. Well done. Run and jump across the gap to the other side of the stream. Good jump. This obstacle is easy to climb. If you know how. First, move close to the wall. Next, jump to grab the edge of the wall and pull yourself up. Good job. I'm most pleased with your progress. You have passed the last test for today. If you wish, you may stay to practice your climbing and jumping, or swimming, ducking, leaning, or crawling. When you are finished, you may return to your chambers by going through that red door. Farewell.
The keepers were training me to be one of them. But I found other uses for those skills.
Woohoo! This leads directly into the mission briefing for the first map, so we will stop here. I will see you very soon with episode 1, and thanks for watching.